Dr. Alan Leica here, and I'd like to welcome you to How to Live a Fantastic Life Show, where we will be discussing the important aspects of your life. We hope to inspire you to live the best life you can. Get out of your comfort zone and explore the awesome world around you. Break through your barriers. Take inspired action. Use the difficulties in your life to achieve the best version of you. Today we've got an amazingly wonderful gal that is a rocket scientist. She is beyond belief. She is such an amazing gal. Rochel Marie, welcome.
Thank you.
Okay. Wow. I just got to catch my breath because it's been such a painful, crazy day. I feel that I've known you forever. You are such an amazing person. Why don't you tell us a little bit about your history so everybody can get to know you as well?
Well, I'm a registered nurse. I'm an Ayurvedic nurse practitioner.
Oh, I know something else about you. You're the queen of feeling fabulous.
Feeling fabulous.
That's what people say about you. You know, that's because you are feeling fabulous and you are the queen of feeling fabulous. How did you get that moniker?
You know, some ladies gave it to me that I met probably about 10 years ago, I guess, because every time they would see me, they're like, how are you doing? Fab. And I would always say fabulous. How are you feeling? Fabulous. You know, so fabulous was my word. So
well, like, I know something else about you, too. Very successful business owner, and you're a practitioner of Ayurvedic. I hope I didn't butcher that too much.
No.
Health medicine. How did you get along that path?
Well, it kind of came from my own journey. I had a 17-year challenge where I had a medical condition that could not be diagnosed for 17 years.
You too, eh? You too,
yeah.
Eh? Back
yeah.
in 2003, I was told I had 6 months to live. I begged to get my affairs in order because I had ALS, Lou Gehrig's disease.
Oh, wow.
I had seen 40 doctors before that diagnosis was made by a world-leading neurologist. He had called me to his office, and when I got there, I was so shocked. All he did was say, you better get your affairs in order, Dr. Leica. You got 6 months to live. You know, that's crazy. That's nuts.
Wow. And
well, you know, it's 2020, and 2003 was a long time ago. 6 months has gone very quickly. I tell you, I didn't have that hitting the wall that he promised me didn't go like he planned it. So, you know, I'm a very blessed person.
Wow.
What's your story about? I bet you it's even more fantastic than mine.
Well, mine started when I was 8, and it was 17 years before.
You remember when you were 8? I can't remember that far back.
Oh, yeah. When I was 8, I had a lot of very significant things happen to me. So 8, I almost want to say when I was 8, 8 was my...
Care to share?
I think it's great because, for instance, my 17-year journey with my health challenge was all related to stress. And the stress that occurred at the age of 8 was the precipitating factor for me suffering for 17 years with an undiagnosed medical condition that I figured out myself when I became a registered nurse. But anyways, so what happened was at the age of 8, I had a couple things. I had 4 things very significantly happen. The first one is at my 8-year-old birthday party, you know, playing with my friends, my cousins, we're getting ready to go out to play outside. It's February, so it's winter, but we're getting ready to go out. I, you know, live in California, so we're getting ready to go outside.
And you ain't seen nothing yet. top of the frozen white board here. It's going to be very cold in the next couple of weeks or months.
Oh my goodness. But I opened the door and my beloved German Shepherd had been hit by a car and literally was dying on my front porch.
Oh my goodness. That must have been terribly traumatic.
Oh, it was very traumatic. So that was the incident number one. Of course, the birthday party ended and my dog ended up dying that night. And then 2 months later, my beloved grandfather, my beloved Sicilian grandfather died. And I spent a lot of time with him, lots of time. I'm the only granddaughter on both sides of the family. So I spent a lot of time with my grandfather. So I was very traumatized by that because he was the one that would take me to school and pick me up and stuff like that, right? And then a couple months after that, my parents announced they were getting a divorce, or I was told that my mom told me that she was divorcing my dad. And, I didn't really know what that meant, but I just knew dad wasn't going to be living with us no more. So,
girl, you sure had a lot of problems there. My goodness, you've already told me a lot of problems. And right. I tell you, this must have been a terribly traumatic time in your life.
It was. And then the last thing was when I was 8, I didn't know it, but I was getting ready to go back to school thinking I was going to the 3rd grade. And I ended up finding out that I had been promoted. So I went from 2nd grade to 4th grade and I had to go to a new school where I didn't.
You lost all your friends and you lost all your buds and you lost all your support group and everything was crazy and you had to learn everything all over again.
Yeah, and I was bullied my whole 4th grade year by a girl that I suffered in silence. So
then that was very common. It was something that happened to a lot of people. Back then, no one spoke about that.
Exactly. I suffered in silence. And so those 4 precipitating things, literally all stress induced. For an 8-year-old to handle. It was my journey to discovering truly what health and well-being means. And so I suffered with my stomach. Basically, my stomach always hurt. And I went to doctor after doctor after doctor. Now, I grew up in the Silicon Valley. So I was at that time living in Palo Alto.
What did you think about doctors then? And what do you think about them now?
I as a little kid, you just do what you're told to do, right?
Yeah,
I eventually got to the point though, when I got to be about 10, so I was in the 6th grade, when I got to be about 10 years old, they would always prescribe me medications and they didn't work. And so I just stopped taking them. And I would tell my mom.
My doctor told me I had ALS. I got very mad at it. I was really angry at him. I could have bitten off his head. I could have really killed him if I was allowed to. It was something that this guy, he had such an awful bedside manner that I just literally hated him. He was an awful guy. You know, what got me through that was I forgave him. And that's something that I think a lot of people don't do and people forget about. Now, forgiveness is not for somebody else. It's for you.
Right.
And really, when you're in a situation where when you need to forgive, it's like being bitten by a snake. That venom goes throughout you forever unless you forgive and get rid of that hate and that stuff. That's what forgiveness is.
Things happen in your life for a reason. You don't always know why you're going down a particular journey or why you veered off your path.
So is that about when you started on this Ayurvedic medicine path, or was it slightly?
So how Ayurveda came, so over the years, at 17 years, I started doing all kinds of things, which was atypical for a kid my age and in the time, growing up in the 70s. But I started doing a lot of things because I just was trying to feel better. And the older I got, the more pronounced my symptoms were and the more pain that I experienced. And so Ayurveda came but just by accident, actually. So I'm going to tell you a quick story. So when I was 25,
Let's hear your story. I love to hear stories.
So when I was 25, I was already working as a registered nurse in the emergency department. Have been doing that for, you know, a little while, and discovered that some of the things that I would share with my patients with regards to things I had learned over the course of the time, of the 17 years, I want to say really from the age of 13 to 25. So the last 12 years, meditation and breathing and massage therapy. And I stopped eating fast food when I was a freshman in high school at the age of 13, because it always made me sick. And, you know, just some of these things, and utilizing herbs and just all kind of stuff. So I figured out what I had myself. I had an ulcer that turned into a bleeding ulcer, and I was able to heal myself holistically and naturally without any medicines or any doctors. And so I'm going to fast forward. So that was 25. So quite a few years later, I was looking at one of my kids was getting ready to go off to college. And I was looking at, like, you know, I want to do something. And my colleagues always said, you should be a doctor. You should go back to medical school. You're so great at diagnosing and honing in.
Not all it's cracked up to be. I went through med school. I did all that stuff. Now I'm glad I'm out of it. I'm glad I'm able to help people in a better way. You know, medicine is a very tough, awful, difficult, crazy field.
And it's really different now than how it was 30 years ago when I, you know, 30 plus years ago when I became a nurse. But lo and behold, I found Ayurveda, and I was like, oh, what's this? And I started looking at it and realized that all the stuff that I had been doing was all Ayurvedic principles. I just didn't know the science or rationale behind it. And so once I discovered that, then I just, you know, went and got a master's degree in it and became an Ayurvedic nurse practitioner, and opened up my second business, focusing on health and well-being, and the rest is history.
So you're a practitioner of Ayurvedic medicine. Do you see patients now?
When I first started the business, it was all, my focus is detoxification. And I had an actual spa, holistic spa, in the city that I lived in Northern California. But I went to a conference and got a bug about speaking and writing, which is something I love to do, and ended up getting numerous requests to speak specifically about detoxification and just Ayurveda in general, and as well as being a business owner, because I have another business that I started. That's another story, but I started before the spa. And so I ended up getting clients globally. I was shown how I could get clients globally and serve people globally, you know, by utilizing the technology that we had available, which was, of course, GoToMeeting, Zoom, things of that nature. And so I ended up having more clients globally than I did that was coming into the spa. And I was speaking so much and traveling so much that I ended up closing the spa. And so now I'm able to broaden my horizon, so to speak, and help people around the world.
Yeah, this COVID thing has been crazy and nasty, but it's had one or two benefits. And one of them, now can go global very easily. For example, this podcast will probably be seen in 70 countries or so. This podcast, it is truly amazing. And I can't believe this simple technology is something that allows us to do such an amazing feat.
I can't believe it either. So I'm going to share something else with you. So my very second degree, which kind of helped me start my first business, is electrical engineer. I'm an electrical engineer.
No, wait, you're an electrical engineer too? Wow.
Yeah.
When did you have the spare time to do that?
Well, listen to this. However, growing up in being born, raised in the Silicon Valley, born in Stanford, growing up in Silicon Valley during the Cold War era in the 70s, where everything was defense contractors and big, you know, all of that, I could not get a job as a female by all those big name companies in Silicon Valley because I was a female. You and know, I was young. I was 20.
What went on there? And I'm always shocked at what we, us whitey guys, did to women. I mean, really, it was a crazy, nutsy world then too. But really, it was not good for women. It was
not at all.
Not good at all.
It wasn't. And you know what was funny is, and I'm calling them out. You know, what can I do? But I was interviewed by IBM, Hewlett Packard, Intel, all those companies that made those chips. FMC, which was a huge defense contractor, you know, because they had those microchips, you know, not the technology we have today, but the ancient technology of the 70s, pre-computer and all of that, personal computer. I was told
when I started, a computer used to take up a whole floor of the department. I didn't get to know very well because you had to be a computer person or get up at 3 o'clock in the morning. I wasn't going to get up at 3 o'clock in the morning to go and talk to a stupid computer just because that's the only time they'd give me. There's no way. Bill Gates grew up in a similar day, but Bill Gates turned on a lot of things, did a lot of things. He and Apple have done so much for the world. It's amazing.
Yeah, it is. It's funny because Microsoft didn't exist when I was in the 70s, and neither did Apple for that. Just to clarify things. So let me say the 80s, because it was really the 80s by this time. But I couldn't get hired. I was told, you know what, honey, and they would say, honey.
Oh, my goodness. You know, oh, what a patronizing, say, you know, awful thing.
Right. But, you know, it was that time when there was no sex discrimination or any harassment things going on. Or there was, but there that's a whole nother story.
Back in 2003, Rochelle, I saw all this stuff going on. And because I saw this going on, I partnered with the YWCA in Canada. And this group, we started a thing to honor women. We started a big production to make women get some of the dues that they deserved. And you know, I saw this crap and I wasn't going to put up with it. There's no way. You know, I was married. I had four daughters and there's no way I was going to let any of them go through this. I wasn't going to let these whitey guys do this crap and do this stuff. So I started this. Boy, the establishment didn't like me at that time. They thought, oh my God, what is this guy doing? He's ruining everything. You know, we got it so good, they used to say, and this guy's just destroying things. How dare he honor women? There's no way.
Right. We should be at home making dinner and have a cigar or, you know, cocktail ready for when the husband comes in.
That's but yeah, thinking that was.
It was a different era, different time. So what happened was, because I couldn't get hired as an electrical engineer in Silicon Valley in the 80s, because I was a woman and I looked like I was 12, and I was told that we would love to hire you, but you're going to be working around guys that are your father's age, and until we can make them comfortable, we've got to figure it out. We'll call you back. Well, I never got the call. I mean, and that was from every company.
We're just running out a little bit of time, so I want to fast forward to today. I want to go and get in, tell these people out here some of the stuff you're doing right now. Can you share a little bit of that like you just did?
Yes. So some of the things I'm doing, of course, I'm helping people. My specialty is detoxification. You don't need to come see me. If you want to come see me, you can, but you don't need to. We can detoxify you virtually, so to speak, but it really.
Do you have a place where people can get in touch with you?
Yes. My website is Blissful Living. the number 4 and the letter U.com. And if you go there, you can find out everything that we're doing, all the programs that I have, as well as I have this woman's summit called the Unstoppable Woman's Summit, turning your passion into your purpose while being fierce, fearless, and unstoppable. And it's about uniting women around the world so that we can support each other, empower each other, connect with each other, strengthen each other, motivate each other, but really to help us unite, because women are change agents. And I believe that our world has come to a place in time where we need women united for the change in the betterment of the world. And so I have six live events planned for, they were planned for 2020, but COVID said, no, not this year. So they're planned for 2021. Got to listen to the good old Corona, the good old coronavirus, and virtual summit. So I'm getting ready to have the second virtual summit, which is happening Saturday, October 17th. And then the third in the series will happen in January 2021. So if you go to my website, you can find out all the details about everything that I'm doing, where I'm going to be, where I'm speaking, what programs, specials, goodies, freebies, all of that stuff, because I really am focused on helping women and men to elevate their wellness, their wisdom, and their wealth. And I'm just the gal to do that. So that's what's going on with me.
You know, I'm so glad you shared your website with people so that they can get on with it and be part of that too. I think that will help a lot of the people out there. You know, I've only known you for a short while, but I feel I've known you forever. Oh. And I think your website and you are amazing. And I really think all our listeners should take part of this and be part of your world and share and learn from you so much that they can, because you have given so much, have so much to give, that I think these listeners will be really benefited by what you do.
Thank you so much. I mean, I feel so humbly honored to be able to be here on your show and just talk a little bit about me and, you know, learn more about you and to be able to share, you know, information. And I'm telling you, if you guys listening out there looking at this, if you go to my website, there's a ton of free stuff, So go if you just want to pick up some free stuff about, you know.
And who doesn't like free stuff, eh? Who doesn't like free stuff? Exactly. Everybody likes free stuff.
Particularly if it's helping you to elevate your wellness, your mindset, wisdom, and wealth, you know, who would not want that? It's the WWW effect.
Okay, everybody, this is Rochel Marie. You need to pay attention, take part in what she has. We're just about our end here. Rochel, what is your secret to living a fantastic life?
Can I say it? No.
Yes, please.
Having lots of sex every, no.
That's a good one. That's a great one. I don't know if our audience will accept that or not, but you know, that
okay,
is.
Okay, let me do it back. Make sure you just really take really good care of yourself, particularly in this day and age. Make sure you eat the best foods you possibly can. You know, do a little bit of detoxification therapies, even if it's just sitting in a warm bath and just letting your body get to a sweaty point and just allowing your body to naturally, you know, expunge some of those toxins we take in. Anything that you can do to help you focus and elevate your immune system, taking, you know, vitamin C and vitamin E and sitting out in the sun and breathing fresh air when you're not around people, anything we can do to elevate our health and well-being by following holistic and natural principles.
Rochel Marie, you got so much together. You got so much that people need to pay attention to. Thank you very much. Stay
You're
well.
You're very welcome.
I'm Dr. Ellen Leica. Make sure you go to drellenleica.com. That's DrAllen. Leica.com, and get a free copy of my book, The Secrets to Living a Fantastic Life, and subscribe to our podcast on this page so you won't miss a single episode. Every week we have exciting guests to help you have the best life you can.